year after I got saved, our bass player Dave came to Christ. Mm-hmm. Totally different testimony. He wasn't looking for God. he was about this far from being dead. I mean, his drug problem was so severe at that point that I actually feared for his life. He ended up on that same bus. We were back touring again with the same band. He was in the front partying. We were in the back praying for Dave because we thought we were going to find him dead in his hotel room. And suddenly there was a knock on that door. And we opened the door, and there's Dave standing there with the most terrified look on his face I've ever seen. A human. He didn't know what was happening to him. And he came into that room, and he said, "I think I'm supposed to be back here."
Wow.
And it wasn't like we had to pray the sinner's prayer. It had already, God had already grabbed this guy. You know, exactly the same thing as Paul's walking down the road, right? Mm-hmm. Where's he going? To kill Christians. He wasn't trying to find Jesus. He's going to kill Christians. God said, "Nope, you're mine." That's exactly what happened to Dave. You know, if you try to formularize it too much, mm-hmm. and gosh, I've never seen a guy so transformed. He's a full-time pastor now. if that doesn't prove it, then I don't know what would.
But Paul's absence, these guys were just trying to come in, and you know, I really don't know, because there really wasn't any money for it. I guess people just do it out of ego. Just, there's always an alpha dog that wants to come in and move into your spot, I guess. But anyway, so here's Paul and these guys in his absence. He started this church in Corinth, and in his absence, there's these guys coming in going, "Everything Paul, he's really not the one of God. We are. You know, we're the real apostles." So Paul's, and there's probably nothing more ridiculous in your life than have to prove who you are or what you are, which reminded me of a story, and this is where you're going to come in handy. When I played in the band, one time we had relocated to Atlanta, and after a couple of years, we actually toured there, and we played in Atlanta, and we had a day off, so I actually got to come home and spend the night in my own house after we played. So the next morning, I went down to a grocery store a couple blocks down, and I guess this person had been at the concert, because I was just going through the line, and they say, "Hey, has anybody told you you look like the bass player for Kansas?" And in any normal circumstances, if it would have been a guy, I would have said, "I've been told that," you know, just to slough it. But since it was a girl, I couldn't resist. I went, and I said, "I am." And she goes, "No." And I said, "Yeah." She goes, "No, you're not." And I said, "Yeah, I mean, I had a handlebar mustache like Eddie's back then, so it was real identifiable, you know, because only a few fine men can grow them." And so anyway, after about three times of battering back and forth of, "Yes, I am who I am," you know, I just said, "Look, lady," I just said, "you know, if I was going to lie about a band, I would have picked a lot cooler one than a bunch of farmers from Kansas, you know. I mean, really, if I'm going to bother to lie, I'm going to make myself a lot better, you know." So anyway, here's these infiltrators in the Corinthian church in Paul's absence, and they're dazzling their church with all these stories. And Paul is going, "Man, guys, you know, they're not." And so he's got to defend his apostleship, and so he's forced into this. Here's what he writes back to him in chapter 11 to the Corinthian church. He says, "Don't make me out to be a fool and make me have to talk like this." He says, "Listen to me as you would an unwise person while I boast a little bit," because he doesn't want to be doing this. He says, "Especially since this boasting is not of God, but rather I'm being forced into it for your sakes, because these so-called apostles have been boasting about their human achievements." Then Paul reluctantly goes on to list many of the things that he's achieved and proof of his authority as an apostle. And then when we come in today's reading, I hope that gives you a little background why this boasting thing's going on, because it's not something he wants to be in. And then Paul suddenly, in chapter 12, just opens up this amazing experience that he had in the Lord. And he goes on to say this to the Corinthians. He says, "I will go on boasting, though it serves no good. Yet I will tell you about visions and revelations from..."